We have a South Carolina man fakes his own kidnapping for a mere $130. Last week, the South Carolina man was arrested because 2 days prior, his mom received a phone call saying that the kidnappers had her son and they would kill and harm him if she didn't get $1,000. So the mom replied, "I don't have $1,000." They went from $1,000 to $500. She didn't have it. They went from $500 to $300. She didn't have it. To now to $250. So these guys say, "Hey, if you can just give me $100 and a pack of cigarettes." The mom says she doesn't have a car, so they said, "Okay, instead of this pack of cigarettes, we'll take $130. So the people said, "Can you go downtown, South Carolina, and put the money?" The mom replied, "I don't have a car. I don't have a vehicle." So they asked her, "Can you sit the $130 on your porch or in your mailbox?" So this one, the mom got a bit suspicious to know that if the criminals want the money set in her mailbox, then they might be local and that her son might have something to do with it. So the next day, the son, he pops up out of the blue. Mom calls the cops. When the cops questioned the son about the situation, he admitted it all, told the whole truth. It was his idea. He was not kidnapped. He just did this because he needed some money. I don't know what he needed some money for. Maybe the new Jordans. Well, the new Jordans cost more than $130. Maybe the new Air Force Ones. You know, that was $100 to give him $30 for his pocket. Maybe the guy just needed some bud, wanted to go get him a quarter of the new, some of that good loud or some of that Kush or something. You know, I was born in South Carolina, and I know the people out there, it is poverty. It is a poverty-stricken state, and people are poor, but this just kicks the bucket right here. This guy just is one of the world's dumbest criminals. The World Dumbest Criminal Award goes to him. Donkey of the day, donkey of the year, and everything else goes to this man. $130, come on now. And the mom knew that something was odd when they said, "You can put the money in the mailbox." Come on now. And it shows how dumb the guy is. As soon as the police questioned him about it, he admitted it all. "Yes, it was me. I done it all." So now the man is in jail facing charges for extortion and blackmail, which he shouldn't be in jail long, because usually when you go off extortion, it usually be thousands of dollars. Extortion is a crime that usually is involved with the mob, where they try to take money from people for protection. They say they'll do something if you give them some money, but it's never been for $135. This is just a waste of the state's money. They probably spent more money coming out to his house to arrest him than the actual $130. I mean, this guy can be locked up for 1 day and pay that $130. You know, it's not even worth a community service. Gassing up the car to take him to community service will be worth more than the $130 that he has to pay back to the city. So I know he will not be in jail long. If anything, he should be released right now and sent back home to face the rest of his community to see what of an idiot he is. I mean, if he has friends or a girlfriend, can you imagine the embarrassment that he has to face now? To face all his people to know you tried to scam your mother for $130. Come on. Most kidnappers ask for thousands. When they continue to go down and go down and go down, the mom said, "Yeah, I'll give you $130. I'm sure if she didn't agree to that, the guys probably would have said, "Hey, give me $20. Then come get the man." The man was purely broke, probably needed a couple dollars to smoke, and he came up with this dumb, idiotic idea. I don't know what made him come up with this one, but it's all caught. And toodles to him, idiot of the day, Mr. Franklin, or whatever his name is, from South Carolina. I'm sure I'll have his name and everything in the title when I drop this video. But make sure y'all like, subscribe, and comment for more updates, because stupid stories like this I like to report on, and I will be reporting more idiotic stories like this, and I'll let you know more about his charges. So peace, Motor City Madness, and we're out.